I'll cross over to Nyayo National Stadium, where a press conference is currently underway in light of the Africa Cup of Nations. And let's just get that update, then we shall be resuming back with more news from business.
You will have, when a ticket is printed, you'll have your gate number and your seat number. So you go to your gate to access your seat. So all you see around here, this VIP will be changed. I believe this that we are sitting on will go. You know, have VIP over here. This fence you see here is also going out. And so what you expect to see is that even that screen, I think, is going also. The lighting is going to be changed. And so many other things. So we will have security control. We'll have PA system that's going to be done. We'll have the lighting change. We have four changing rooms on that side. So from now, players at Nyayo will be coming from that side. Then we'll only have referee changing room here because we have four changing rooms per stadium. Per venue, you need four because you have two matches. So if you have a game at 4 and another one at 8, you must have every team being in a changing room. I'm sure many of you journalists have been in this tournament. You know how it is done. But I just want to explain what you will see in every stadia that you go to. Each of our stadia, that's what you're going to see. And that's generally what we have to do in each of them now. Secondly, in the training venues, the insistence is that the grass we are going to do in each of the venues, we are going to have Bermuda grass in each of the venues. So this grass you see here will go completely. It will be removed and replaced. Then we'll replant again. By November, end of November, beginning December, is when the grass will be ready for each of the venues. Now, each training venue also must be like the venue you'll train. You must have lighting so that if you're going to play at night, you train at night the previous day. That's a requirement. So those are the requirements you need to see. I think I wanted also, I'm sure you guys know the countries coming, so Congo, Libya, Morocco, Cameroon, Nigeria, Uganda, Zambia, Angola, Equatorial Guinea, Mauritania, Sudan, Ivory Coast, Burkina Faso, Namibia, Guinea, and then of course Kenya will be the host. So just to share that, I thought it's important. We can take questions now. Mike.
Mr. President, it's very easy to say that you need the media support.
Yes.
And we'll be ready. And as it is,
yes.
If you look at Nyayo, today is when something is being done out there.
Yes.
Now, question is, what are the timelines? When do we expect to see this floodlight being changed? When do we expect to see the first seat being riveted?
Yes.
When do we expect to see an update on what is going on?
Yes.
On the same note,
yes.
What has taken so long? And we knew the amount of work to be done.
Yes.
Yet nothing has been done. Thirdly,
yes.
You say that only two games, today and on Sunday.
Yes.
Is the Federation willing to risk a derby with all the debris out there?
So let me attack your question in three parts. One is the delay. All right? We all accept, Mike, that there's been delay. Delay has come from many things. Government systems, government processes from September last year. Those delays have been there. So as a federation, we said, when you have delays, we have seen in Rwanda, I'm informed that when the games were being played, they were still fixing stuff. So we said there's delay, but does that mean that we couldn't do it? So we said there's been delay, we pack that. There's been many reasons, processes in government, maybe many things that maybe we won't talk about so much because there's no value in it. I think the question is whether there will be such delay again. I think for us, that is a key thing. From what we have seen from government and from doing the tenders when the inspection was here, from giving the contracts, from these guys burning midnight oil to make sure that the contracts go out and they are given and they are signed, we are confident that that delay is behind us, that we've had. Of course, it is late. So now, then we go to your question about when you expect to see what has been done. The contractor who's here is already on site for the last couple of days. Not done much. So what he's waiting for is for these two matches to end so that he can demolish things. So from Monday going forward, you will see demolitions. And every day, Mike, there will be a project plan pinned down here, which you guys can access and see the last 3 days what has been done. So the first phase he's doing is what we call builder's work. Builder's work is these things, moving them, changing them, installing physical structures, civil works that he explained. Now, after that, then you will have the other vendors who are tournament vendors who install the PA system, who install the ticketing system, who install the lighting.
Well, that is Nick Mwendwa just giving an update as Kenya.